everybody, I'm Norman Brannon. Now, admittedly, I'm a bit more of a Paul Smith or a Fred Perry guy, but I get it. Today, when you think of 21st century menswear, there are a lot of guys out there who don't think that it's manly enough. Now, one design team in New York City decided to address the problem, and the result is a label that's as much ready-to-wear as it is leatherware. They also use rubber, lots of it. But what would you expect from a brand called Nasty Pig? Let's go inside. So why don't you tell me a little bit about the story of Nasty Pig and basically how it started?
Well, my partner and I started Nasty Pig in 1993 with $50. We went out and bought some fabric and made some shirts for friends and just let it grow from there.
And when you say your partner, you mean actually your real life partner?
My everything. We kind of built this company on word of mouth because we didn't have any money for anything other than making product. And eventually enough people have good things to say about you that it starts to tip over into a larger audience.
And there's also been a lot of attention in the press, which is kind of leading me to believe that you guys are crossing over on some level from your original gay clientele.
We're seeing the crossover really happen because culture is shifting. We have young gay and straight kids who come in here who 10 years ago, the same audience would never walk in here, and they just get off on the fact that we're real. You know, we're kind of the great American dream.
The first thing you notice when you walk in, if you actually get past the awning and get in, is that this isn't a fetish shop.
I don't care what something is made of. To me, I want you to look in the mirror and feel sexy. And that's kind of what our brand is about. It's not a material or a style. It's about, you know, bringing out confidence in a guy and allowing him to express himself in a slightly more overt manner.
Can you tell me a little bit about the rubber? Like, what makes that different from, like, the rubber on the bottom of my shoe?
Okay, well, it's a synthetic rubber that we manufacture, and it's machine washable, it's really supple. It's just great, durable stuff, and, you know, anything that you can fool around in and throw in the wash it works for me.
Now, speaking of fooling around with rubber, one of your biggest items, or at least most renowned with Nasty Pig, let's take a look at this. We've got play sheets, right?
Yes.
These are rubber.
Yes.
Bed sheets.
Yes. The whole idea is abuse, wash, repeat. They're for screwing. You know.
What do you think is the male obsession with underwear these days?
I mean, for me, a nice pair of tidy whities is about as sexy as it gets, and it's a fun way to express yourself. I mean, male fashion has gotten so jeans and t-shirts that the elastic of your underwear has become some place where you can actually express what fashion used to allow you to do with your whole look.
And what do you define as the Nasty Pig culture?
It's intelligent and subversive and sexy and ironic. And, you know, those are the things that I try to build into our brand is authentic, you know, gay sensibility. And that's, you know, that's something that's very unique to us.
Now, you guys have been in business for a long time, but some people might say that you can only kind of take this look so far. So how do you see the future of Nasty Pig style?
I definitely see us subverting more white collar looks, but if you've got a great brand, then the sky's the limit. And what we're seeing happening here is our brand crosses over without us sacrificing the integrity of what we do. To me, the sky's the limit. I used to see a lot of restrictions, and now they've all been torn down.
Well, I want to thank you for having us.
Thank you very much.
It's been
Appreciate
an amazing
it.
Time. And if you're ever
Thanks,
in New
guys.
York City, come down to 19th Street and visit the Nasty Pig store or nastypig.com online. Thanks a lot.